Hi, and welcome back to our Open Stop Motion Film Project. I hope everyone had a good weekend. Today we are some of all those trees here. We are gonna prepare them so we can paint them like we have done with all of those behind here. So, and there are a lot of them. So we can tie it all a little together. We have so many loose ends, so we need to do something about that. And that's what we are doing in these days. And I think I take so much. Let me see here if I have done this right. I have. So, just for precaution. And what I'm doing is that, as you can see, if I take one here, you can see where I have glued this stick in between. There's some cracks and it don't fit together 100%, so I am putting some clay around it and cover the cracks. And this is a fastest way to do it. Some of the early ones I made, I used plastic padding, and that's some very nasty stuff to work with, and it kind of is hard to sand down again to where I wanted to. So this is easier. So, and I have to find methods where the work is kind of easy. So I spent as little time as possible on every one of them. Even though I still have to make them like they have to be nice and so on. But these are fill trees. So we are not going to get any close-up of any of these, but they still have to be nice. Couple of hundreds of these trees, so. And we want them to look like this. Now I have to be careful not to. You can see, like this one, this is pretty much the same, or it is the same. So you can see when it's painted, then it's looking quite different. and those who were watching last time, maybe remembered that I thought I had some problem with the hard drive, but I didn't. It was the block in the side of the computer that was the problem, and that was a good thing. That was one of the backups. And but I'm gonna order a 5 terabyte external hard drive to make some new backup of. Sync to. And I put some oil on the fingers, so it's easy to smooth out. So you cannot see it when they are painted. I hope I'll be able to paint all of them this week. I'll see how long it takes to do it. Okay, finish that one. And this was the first one I tried. If it worked, and it did. Just to fill in the cracks and so that you cannot see it's put together like this. There are many possibilities with some clay. Next. Oh, oops, sorry. I hit the mic. Thank you. take one of these. We can even it out. Print this a little thinner. Sorry. Nice. Thank you. And it's finally getting summer here. It's so nice. Oh, late spring. Early spring. Oh. The weather is good, anyway. The sun is shining all day. We had a long and gray winter. So. And I'm waiting for my little friend the swallows to arrive from Africa. They're always such fun. And we have a lot of them around here. It's actually barn swallow, but I live in the town, but it's mostly barn swallow that is here. I love to photograph them. Maybe because it's so hard, because they are so incredibly fast. They are small and fast and very elegant flyers. So, and a beautiful little bird too, with a lot of character. They are some small top cookies. They are not afraid of any of the big birds. And I use my, I have a 300 millimeter Canon L lens. That's a really good for that. A prime lens. Then I use my 7D. The 5D I have is too slow to catch them. And the 7D is very fast. So my 5D is a 5D Mark II. So I think the 5D Mark III is fast enough, but. When I have a 7D also, then there's no need for, in my opinion, for a new 5D. Not now, at least. So. Oh, let's see, the hot glue is getting outside here. We need to cut that off. Thank you. See if I can do it without losing any fingers. That's the problem when you hurry and don't do a good work, then you have problems later on. And this was not good. So, but we will fix it. If I have done it right the first time, that wasn't necessary then. So, okay. Thank you. Stopmotion. So, one more ready. And I see it goes much, much faster than with the plastic padding. Much less messy. That's kind of the stuff you figure out along the way. How to do and what to do. Sometime you'll make twice the work you need to do because there sometimes is a easier way to do it. Staring you in the face without you seeing it. I think we all have tried that. I need to get some more oil. But where have I put it? Get some more if I can find it. First, I want to clean my hands a little. That was a surprise. It was on its place. I think I'm soon ready to buy a new one. Maybe we should hear what on Twit podcast today. In triangulation with Leo Laporte and who was?
That's right. There's definitely a type of woman that makes, you know, I used to
Robin Hauser. Reynolds.
I was actually working for Nomura Securities in Luxembourg. And listen, that was a really a male dominated industry, right? Of course it was. Oh, yeah, absolutely. I didn't let it deter me. I loved what I did. It was super fun, you know? I'm now a female director of the film show.
And,
someone asked me the other day, what's it like to be a female director? I said, I've never been anything but a female director.
The netcast I listen to is live.twit.tv. A very good place to get a little wiser on tech stuff and a lot of other things. You are absolutely right. If you couldn't hear it, the nonsense they are talking about, people are left or right brains or women agenda, where they say girls are not good at math and that kind of stuff. That is pure nonsense. It's a shame that it is like that. Some people are good at math, some are not. But it's nothing to do with gender.
Jobs, whilst the
Need some coffee.
Am I making sense? I think it's very confusing.
I think, though, that what this is
I remember asking her once in an interview, you know, well, so what can men do? What do men need to do? She looks at me and had a little bit more colorful language than I'll use here, but she basically said, just get the heck out of the way. Right? Just get the heck out of the way. We're coming. And I love that, you know, and I actually think that it's get out of the way and let women into the space, and then let's work together. And let's work together and create some really amazing things.
Love it.
Right?
And moms and dads, let's bring your daughters and sons to maker spaces and hacker spaces. Give them tools at home, give them little bits, whatever it is, so that they can have the opportunity to. It's such an exciting area. Your mind just, I mean, admittedly, not everybody's cut out for this, male or female, but I would guess just as many girls are cut out for this as boys. Give them the tools to discover this, and you may be amazed at what happens. We're going to have more with our guests. We're talking about a new movie. It's it debuted at the Tribeca Film Festival in New York City last night. The big film festival, Code, debugging the gender gap. First, let's talk about money. Money has no gender bias, but that you have to take care of it. PersonalCapital.com/ I guess this is Robin Hauser Reynolds. She's the producer and director of really, I cannot recommend this film more highly. Code, Debugging the Gender Gap. I was fortunate because I was provided with a secret, don't ask me for an online link. How do we get this film out? Is going to the film festivals your first step in getting distribution?
Yeah, we'll have distribution. We already have interest in distribution.
Good.
So it will be distributed. That's we know for certain. And it takes a little bit of time because right now we're on the film festival circuit. We can't have wide distribution, you know, if we're on the festival circuit. And festivals are fun. It's a great way to get the film out. It's fun for the coding team, but it's a great way for the directors and producers and editors and part of the team to sort of enjoy having made the film. Educational distribution is a really important thing to me, so to all of us on the Code team. So we will absolutely make this, you know, film available to colleges, universities, and institutions. I'm looking for funding now. We're going to bring it down to under an hour piece so that we can bring it into high schools. I think it's really important to have it be something that's maybe 52, 54 minutes. So that'll be great. And again, you know, already through email, we're getting all sorts of requests and inquiries on when can they screen it, how can they screen it. And then there'll be distribution too. It'll be made available for corporations too, people that want to show this to their companies. And we'll have international distribution. And then eventually, yes, it'll be on streaming. It'll be hopefully Netflix. It'll be all over. We'll look for broadcast too. So it'll be probably by this time next year, it'll be readily available.
Good.
You'll probably walk into Walmart and get it. So.
Knocking on wood, Robin. That's great.
Yeah.
You had a panel after the festival last night. How did that go?
Panel was great. It was really interesting. We actually had to finally stay. I'm sorry, last question. I mean, I think we could stay there for another 45 minutes. It was it was great. We had an executive from Qualcomm, one from GoDaddy, another from Etsy, and it was one of the entire
excellent. There's one space I think where we're starting to see a lot of women is in the tech blog. I think that's great. And you know, a lot of those women end up on our network as contributors.
Hey, yeah.
Thank you, Robin. had 3 or 4 women in the chat room. Fight the good fight, thank you. And a couple of guys fight back, of course. These guys are ones to do. Chat room is a big part of this show, so please, if you can't watch live, do. Otherwise, on demand, audio and video always available at twit.tv/TRI. We have it on iTunes. We have everywhere you get your podcasts, your mobile device. And of course, the Twit apps and all the mobile devices. Thanks for bringing your party developers. If you get one of those, you can just subscribe and you won't miss a single episode. That's how I like it. Thanks for being here. We'll see you next time on Triangulation. Thank you, Robin. I got you out just in the nick of time.
Perfect. Thank you so much. That was fun. I hope that was all okay. I should probably, brush my hair and wash my teeth.
Oh, you look great. Oh, don't worry about that. See? You see the inherent sexism? I've never said that. Ever. Take me as I am. Fat and ugly. I'm here, baby.
I should stop saying that, too. That's actually, you're right. That's the imposter syndrome that I'm suffering from.
Oh, believe me, I suffer. We all suffer. Nobody believes they earn any of this. So that's...
Listen, would love to, when I'm back on the West Coast, we should grab coffee.
You're down the road.
I'm right down the road.
And as I said, our CEO is a woman. We try as much as possible to get women on the air, and people of color, too. It's really a hard thing to do. It tends to, a lot of our shows tend to be white men.
I can set you up with some pretty amazing women in tech, so we should maybe via email or something get one of your producers to contact us, because...
Yeah, you have some great people that I'd love to talk to on the movie. That's great. Right. Thank you.
Good. Okay.
Robin, take care.
Thank you.
Bye. I got her up at 11:58. How about that?
Hold on. All right, so we have 3 ads to do, and then I'll be beginning of the show.
Yeah. Well, we did the beginning. Oh, yeah, that's it. Let me do the beginning of the show stuff first. This is Triangulation, episode 197, recorded Monday, May 20th, 2015. Code, debugging the gender gap. Let's use that instead of her name. I think that'll be more understandable. Triangulation is brought to you by Truck Club. Have the wardrobe you've always dreamed of handpicked by your own personal stylist. Go to truckclub.com/twit and join Truck Club today. And by Blue Apron. Blue Apron will send you all the ingredients to cook fresh, delicious meals with simple step-by-step instructions right to your door. See what's on the menu this week and get your first 2 meals free by going to blueapron.com/twit. That's Blue Apron. Did I say make 20th? That's blueapron.com/twit. And by Personal Capital. With Personal Capital, you get award-winning financial tools, unbiased advice, and a transparent view of all your investments. As well, it's free. To sign up, go to personalcapital.com/triangulation. This is Triangulation, episode 197, recorded Monday, April 2015.
We are driving in oil.
Yeah.
we can cover this crack. Where is it? There it is.
There's no subscription. It's not going to come every month. It's not one of those things you forget.
You can see the crack in the print. Cracks anymore.
Check out this week's menu. Get your first two meals free. Oh, put your first two meals free. They're waiting for you. Don't be thinking so much of this word of triangulation. That looks... Was it as good as it looked?
Everything that I made... So I made now six different meals, and we signed up for ourselves. So, and I forgot to sign up with the offer.
Oh, I saw it.
I completely agree. But yeah, it's okay, because we had, you know...
Did you use glass to shoot?
Yeah, I did that. Yes, I used glass for...
a good use for glass. Jason, you just paid for your Google Glass.
Hey, there we go. Hey, it comes in handy for stuff like
that's a perfect use for it.
Like, I want to shoot something.
Because you're chopping.
Process. That's perfect.
I mean, and the video was excellent.
Yeah, it looks pretty good.
Of course, it helps that you're 8 feet tall. Nice. Thank you for doing that.
Oh, absolutely.
The B-roll is phenomenal. That makes such a big difference because I mean, you can really see.
Totally.
And that looks good.
Yeah.
Was that a minted yogurt sauce? What was that?
It's a Greek yogurt sauce, a little, chopped up mint in there, a few other things I can't remember, but, and then you keep the recipe.
Right. And you have the confidence because you've done it, that you know, I know how long this goes, or whatever. You use it all the time, right, Dave?
It's nice.
Does Jerry do it, or do you do it? And what, does he like doing it?
We did one with chicken and dumplings, which I never knew how to do.
Oh, I love chicken. Isn't that a good meal? Now you can do it, right? And it's a starting point. You can say, you know, I want more parsley or whatever. I love that.
Wow.
You don't like parsley? Always want more.
Yeah, you might want more.
More parsley, or maybe less. More pepper, maybe less. Chicken and dumplings. Man, I want them. Really. You can tell it's lunch. Now, first look at it. I hope, I'm sure you are saving for your pension, planning for retirement, a rainy day, maybe your first house. And I hope you're paying attention to things like
next.
That your world is
living target. Or maybe not that living. This is print when the thin thread gets on it. They are very, very thin. Then they're difficult to get away. Keep sticking to you. Have a mean for that. threat remover. That works. This is not going to work as I wanted to. Can do something about it. There was too little glue on this one. Absolutely. That and put some more on. Shoot it with this gun, and then sorry with my back. I need to mount some plugs under the table, so I don't have to. Stand on my head every time. I will run a second while this one is getting hot. Go. A little more. A little hotter. But in the meantime, put something on the next one. Is that right? And what we hear in the background is Twit live.twittv. Or what? live.twit.tv. That's how it is. With Leo Laporte, and I think next they are sending is MacBreak Weekly. No, it's iPad. This Week in iPad or something like that. Are they coming in a little while? And it is okay to listen to them while we are working. Yes, tread on also. Be careful not to burn the mic. Shall we see if we can get any glue out of this? We can't. And used too much. But we will cut it off. So, you'll wait a little bit. And then we will cut it off. And this one, we will hook. A lot of glue on this one. I think we shall give every one of them a little right of that burner. Oops, put that on there again.
Thank you.
Oh.
Do you guys have app paths?
That was where my nades dug in. So. You can simply not be rid of those thread, but you can with this one. Season. I don't know if you can, but they are on here. But now they aren't. Oops. And the last one. Go. They are so irritating because you keep on dragging them around, and they will not leave your hand or the clay or whatever. It just sticks to everything, and that's not what we wanted to. So, and some of you may wonder why I don't make short videos instead, and because then I have to edit them too. And the time I will be editing will take time from this, because there are only me. So the idea with all of this is, of course, not for you to sit through 4 hours of me playing with clay, but just once in a while, come by and see how it's going, if a stop motion movie and how they are made are something that interests you. And if not, there are a lot of other stuff for YouTube. And I guarantee you that you can find something that lay your heart near. Or are near to your heart, I think they are saying. The right saying is. So, it's the only way I can do it. If I ever want to make a stop motion movie. But if it was all about making videos to YouTube, I would not choose to make stop motion if the only thing that counted was have a lot of viewers and stuff like that. It is not. I'm an old guy, so I decided I want to make a stop motion movie. And that needs everything I have in me to get that done. And most people would probably not give a S word. But that's okay. The only reason I haven't on YouTube is that that's the only way I can embed it on my site. Before I had it on Justin, but as you all know, or some of you know, that Justin got bought by another company, and then they just said goodbye, and then I lost all my viewers, and I had really a lot of viewers, kind of a couple of thousand per night, maybe the Justin audience are another kind of audience, I don't know, I and how. But I couldn't even say goodbye to them, because just one night Justin put up a message that goodbye and thank you, and I was a paying customer, so that was a little disappointing. So, and I don't, I know I'm reaching out to a very narrow niche audience if I am reaching out to any audience at all. And so if I could, I would only put it on my site. But I cannot do that. I cannot upload video to that. And there are, believe it or not, people who are a little interested in this. Not many, but a few. So hey.
She was really more a call for help person. Yeah, she was both. I mean, I think she eventually became a call for help person. Before that, it was all of us were.
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am.
Someone has stolen my...
Everything else would be handled.
Nope.
She is already way interested in different things.
it's not specifically iPad specific.
No.
In fact, no wonder, do teenagers use
iPads? That's the thing. I think a lot of them are really on their phones, mostly. But, you know, all of these apps are available on the iPad. So if you want to see what apps your kids are using and you want to take a look at them, you know, while you're sitting on the couch, I thought I would go through some of them. And I thought we would talk about three main things that, as far as I can tell, teenagers are doing, the different apps they're using. I think there's the dating app, which apparently teenagers are using.
That blows me away. Because if anybody doesn't need a dating app, it seems like it would be teenagers, right?
Right, yeah. I mean, both of us came up, we didn't have any dating apps.
We were five.
Right, but I mean, I understand that they work for single adults, and they're sometimes a better match than meeting people at a bar.
So kids
or
can use dating apps?
Yeah, there's one, first of all, I've got dating apps, there's the commenting on life kind of apps, like Yik Yak is the biggest one, just anonymous, like I want to comment on the teacher, I want to comment on this person, and then there's the chat app, which are... like.
And I'll show Snapchat, because I think Snapchat is one that really scares parents, and I think unnecessarily.
Right.
But it's also very popular. So
yeah.
we'll give you a little tour of what your kids might be using.
Yeah.
And what to be looking for. Let me ask you, right up front, what's your philosophy about...
Best, but...
Yeah.
So, shall we try? There's a little crack in there.
Yeah.
interesting thing that's going on with Snapchat. First of all, big brands have discovered Snapchat. Snapchat set up this Discover page. And, this is something that's really aimed more at adults. I don't see the kids who use Snapchat as looking at it. I asked Henry, do you ever look at this? He says, he didn't even know it existed. I think brands like ESPN see this as a really valuable thing to do, because if you think about it, mostly what you want is just some hits, and even like highlights, and Snapchat's perfect for something like this, right? So I actually think this is a good platform for ESPN and short, but I don't think the kids care at all about that.
But what's interesting, what's happening with Snapchat is the same thing that happened with Instagram or any company as it becomes bigger.
So
Your
called.
One of the problems is they're heavily used for bullying.
Yes.
And all the companies that make these products are very worried about this and try to do their best to discourage bullying.
Right, but yeah, so GIFYAC is just it is designed for schools, and you can show my screen, but I would be careful because it's.
Well, people can yip you.
I said you could show it, which I should have said.
Look now and see.
I think it's okay now.
Okay. And that's because it's, and this is really important. These aren't people messaging you. These are all the messages in the area.
Right. So I don't even want to scroll too much. But you can, if you see something offensive, you can always vote it down. And
like, how about that one? I like you a lot. Show that one again. I like you a lot, but I'm pretty sure you only see me as a friend.
Right.
Now that's anonymous.
Yeah. But it's in my area.
It's in your area.
Yeah, I have allowed. So it was like.
So it's like passing notes at school.
Yeah, there was a comment about the diet beyond glory, which is,
Next.
Yeah, and you can peek into other locations.
I can see how attractive this would be.
And then I hope in next week we can start making leaves to them. And a lot. Or maybe already this week.
Right, yeah, there was a professor that complained that didn't complain, but this is beyond free speech because it's just.
That would be.
It's on the internet for everyone to see, and if it's just one, it's like this is what happens when we have nice things. it's like one person has a voice, and they.
You can see why parents are scared. I mean, I didn't have to deal with this when I had teenagers, and it's gotten more and more scary. You're going to be going into this. I think for the next few years, I've had today, this will be kind of a running. Topic as we watch Annabella and then Lionel and Huck kind of enter the teenage years and the struggles you have. But I think it's great. This is what we did when we did Jumping Monkeys, the parenting show for digital parents, is really talk about these experiences. So if you're a parent of a teenager, we'd love to hear from you and let us know what your experience has been, what tools you've used, what you've let your kids do, what you don't let them do. I do have to say, fundamentally, I'm a kind of a laissez-faire parent. I feel like conversation with and so, for instance, I'll give you an example. Michael, who was playing these Gary's Mod, one of the things Steam lets you do with Gary's Mod is trade items. And as with most games, you collect special items, fantastic items, some of which you pay for. And he does occasionally get as a reward some Steam bucks to buy these things. Steam has a system, which I think is great, that if he's played, first of all, I make sure he plays on my account. I would recommend this, because as a parent, you will get an email anytime you buy something. The $150 suit of armor, where's your piggy bank? but you'd also, one of the things that happens is you do meet people online, maybe you don't know, and there is often the option to trade items, valuable items. Michael wants to be liked. And so sometimes people will come to him pleading poverty, saying, oh, I can't afford it. I see you have a great suit of armor, a really cool gun. Would you be willing to trade? So the good thing about Steam, if he's on your account, and I would encourage that, is that you'll get an email before a trade happens saying, this person wants to trade this for your thing. Is that okay? And you as the parent get to approve this. Highly recommend that. And then the conversation with Michael is, do you know this guy? Why do you want to give him this stuff? And it's actually a great opportunity to open up a conversation in general about the internet, who's on the internet, what kinds of stuff you want to do on the internet. And the conversation is the most important, not the policing, but the conversation.
Yeah, I totally agree. And I mean, you have to have that kind of conversation. Like I talked before about Facebook and Instagram becoming a stricter
certainly, if your kids have given you reason for doing so, why are sneaking out of the house and things like that, then it's okay. I think it's completely okay to shut down venues to start being more restrictive. But my general idea is let the kids use Steam, let the kids use this stuff as long as you can see it, you have the password, you're involved with the interactions, and you use every interaction as a teaching moment. Because ultimately, they are going to go out of the internet. Right? They are going to be in these environments. Better now that you, that they experience this stuff in a certain way.
And the top.
Sarah did all this. No, I don't know. Well, I'll get to the voicemail later.
Later.
Definitely iPad today at twit.tv.
That's
This one was a little rough printed. So, you can see. So. Got that.
You send it to them, they turn around fast. They'll wipe the data if you forget to.
Fill it up.
In fact, adjust your quote if you're thinking about more. They will adjust it up. I've never heard of a company doing this, but it's happened to me twice now. So,
I have to be a little careful. My neck are really making trouble in these days. Next one is like in the doctor's office, calling the patients in. Oops.
Yeah. surprise you?
No, no, I was fairly shocked that they were able to raise a bond issue. For one reason, these were 30-year bonds for a device that will be obsolete in 3 years. That seemed like a bad fiscal policy. But also, I'm not convinced an iPad is something that every kid needs. What I do agree with is the motivation here, which is that every kid, whatever means, there are many kids in the Elliott High School District who come out of fairly poor homes, in some cases extremely poor homes, should have access to digital technology and education, as we spoke earlier,
right,
in digital technology. That is important.
Well,
the iPad's exactly the right thing.
Correct. It was this kind of idea, well, all these wealthy kids have iPads, so everybody should have an iPad. But, like, maybe the wealthy kids shouldn't have an iPad, you know?
And stop.
At least anyway, I rarely just open the browser and surf. It's almost always because I click the link in Twitter and it opens the browser. So I don't bother. It's funny because I do use Chrome on other platforms.
Yeah.
On the iPad, I just.
Well, there was
so what did they do?
There was three updates. One, they integrated, made it easier to integrate your last pass or your one password.
Safari before, so that's a catch.
And next living picture. Okay. Be careful now.
You log in though, every single there's really people who grew up in the 70s. 1977 was the episode 3 of the very first Star Wars movie. Boy, is that confusing. New Hope. And anybody who was in a formative period in 1977 will never forget that moment, right? I mean, that was a really critical part of our evolution. So the ability now to get it, now a couple things I'm going to say.
Okay.
First of all, you can buy it on iTunes, but you can also buy it on other sites. Google has it, and Amazon has it. Here's something interesting. There's a site called Disney Anywhere.
We talked about that here, you and I did.
Did we talk about
this? Yes, because you can buy it.
We already had this conversation.
No, but not about Star Wars. I didn't put those two together. Disney, Star Wars.
So don't buy it from Disney. Now, this is really weird because Fox has the rights to the first movie, episode 3. That's confusing. So, hey, how many times do I have to say that? Four. Episode 4. Now, see, I'm confused. Episode 3 is the one they're making right now. So episode 4, which was the very first movie, was made by, is owned by Fox, and Disney doesn't have the rights to it. But if you buy it, and I think you would normally buy it on iTunes. So if you buy it on iTunes, long ago and far away.
So. We have made a couple. By now. It's not just the same we said, but even it could look like that. But the bad part is that we have many, many more. And then think how many hours it took to print them. I'll have to go through a lot before it get good. And that's how it is with everything. Isn't it?
I had
should have a picture of Bert saying I didn't steal your cell.
And you have to get them back. That was that. I think we need to do something about that. Because that wasn't working. Ah, stop it. Cracking everything right now. We need to glue a little. I think I missed something else too. I don't know. That was not intended, but that's how it ended anyway. Too much.
It saved my game where I left off. That's a good thing. Okay, we're in chapter 2, I think, of this game. Yeah. The kid warned me a monster was coming and I should hide in the locker. I don't know what was crazier than I got in the locker, but what happened next was terrifying. There's something in here doesn't sound human. Shall we continue? They also recommend do you wear headphones. There's a lot of left-right stereo on here. And I can walk. This is where I've already been, so you can see what this is.
Shall we see? It smells like it. You will see. It works.
Kind of my helper. Like the kid in charge.
$7 is not a cheap game. It is much like the kid right there on the Denver block.
So, try one more. No, I can't stand there and get cold. Copy. It don't give any meaning to listen to that anymore. When they are talking games, then we need to see it. For it to be any fun. Ain't that right? Careful not to squeeze too much. And I know this is not the most exciting thing in the world to look at. But there is a... Here in the start, there is a lot of repetition of stuff. As we do now. But as farther we get into the process, the better it will be. and the more interesting to look at it will be too. And I'm every day I'm thinking of how we can make it more interesting. But the video part is no go. I will not be editing video, but so it will be live. And stop his life, then it is real. And in the real world, you cannot make a full-blown stop-motion movie in half an hour. That's not possible. I think this is the world first where you can see the whole process from the very beginning to the end. I don't know of other places where you can that. Yeah, small Lego ones or something like that, but a full-blown one, you are not gonna find anywhere where you are able to follow all of it. I thought I had burnt all of that shit off. Okay, sorry for the language. And every episode I have made are up on my own site, or most of them, at least. A couple of them we had technical issues with, but most of them are up on pixelfantasies.com. In the archive, stop motion archive. You can see when we started, I started doing the figures in real clay and had a lot of problems with that part. They cracked we had to finish it in a hurry, and you cannot put something on if you don't do it while at the, you only have one shot and then you have to do it, finish it. And that was a little difficult. And then we started in this. Much better. And then we got better cameras all over the place too. And even if it don't look like that, we have got a lot of stuff done. I have tons of heads and animals and whatnot. So sooner or later we will get there. But a work this big, you have to endure the what do we call it? The journey. If you don't, you will never get it done. You will run out of steam before you get to the end. So you have to be a little masochistic to, and stubbornness is a good thing too. And that's something I is good at, stubbornness. Do it even if I have to make it all myself. That's how stubborn I am. Ah, Now I broke this too. My God. It was, these are printed while the extruder on the printer was bad. So the layer are not that good. Bound together, what we call it. That's one of the reasons I listen to English podcast all the time, is to improve my of course, because I'm interested in tech when I listen to it, but also so I improve my English. Because when you are speaking your native tongue in the day, then it's hard to pronounce things right when you come to the evening and do this. The best way to learn a language is to take to the country or travel to the country and learn it there, live in the country, learn it. But that's not possible. So and the older you get, is the harder is it to change language. Even then, I have worked with people from, in my younger days, I have worked with people from all over the world, but and was pretty good at it, but now it's very rusty. And harder to get back. What is she? What it used to be? I have worked at firms that where we were talking English all day long, because the people around me was from all over the world, from many different countries. I need to get a little heat on this again. Yep. So we can glue it. Most kids nowadays are really good at it, at least this part of the world, because the net and stuff like that. And when you are young, you have something. Easier to learn. I will hopefully get better at it. Is it time for a smoke? I think so. When we are finished with those I have on the table here, we have made 25 of these tonight. And that's not bad. But there are many more to come. And then we have to get a lot of polystyrene to build the stuff on the table. And now I got the hiccups. I think it's ready now. Yep. So we can give it a little. Side. See all those threads? That's the worst about hot glue. Missing a piece on the top there. You can see it broke off. And I don't know where it went, but I'll find that afterwards. So we can stick it on there again. Oops. Maybe it was always already broken off. I think I have some pieces somewhere else. When I take one out of the bunch, then sometimes all of them tumble, and then they break. That's why I left the little foot on, but it's not always enough, because they're pretty tall comparison to the foot they are standing on. So they're pretty easy to get out of balance. But when we stick them to the scenery, we are gluing them so they don't tilt. Little hold on them. But I'll paint these I have on the table before I put them over again. Because then they are finished. And we can get on with the new ones. So we get forwards all the time. We do that anyway, but visible forwards. And then I have a whole box full of some of those I use plastic padding on. I have to sand down with the machine. But we'll do that at last. But that I regret now that I mount this way. That's how it is. Which one was? The one we broke? I don't know. Hope it's dry now. Make leaves to all of them, and that is an enormous undertaking. And first then they will start to look like real trees. But we will see. We cannot find a method that makes it a little easier than put one leaf on at a time. That's kind of consuming. A big time spender. Thank you. So, oops. Take this one. Yes. I think tomorrow, if the weather is the same as today, I will take a trip to the woods, take some pictures before there is leaf on all the trees. Good with a little inspiration. That's needed sometime. I can find some good tree models. I know I can just Google tree image on the net, but it's different to see it in real life. because I also need to make some scrubs on the forest floor. I don't have figured that out right yet. How to and we have some untouched woods around here where they don't what do we call that? Where it's kind of left to its own devices. So it's kind of like there really was many of the forest nowadays are kind of, I don't know what you call it, but commercial forest where they are planted in long rows and ready to cut down when they are big enough. And that's not how they look in the Stone Age. So we wanted it a little more ungroomed, if that makes any sense. And we have some of those. When a tree falls, it just get left alone and rot or animals building in it and let it rot. Sorry. I need something to drink for that one. Four hours and 25 degrees. As far as I can count. And that was all of those I took on the table, so. Now I of course have to dry all the, wipe all the oil off them before I paint them, but that I can do with a cloth. This was more or less all of it for today. And another 6 or 8 gigabyte is on the hard drive. I guess. So I will say thank you for today and thanks for watching, and see you again tomorrow, hopefully. And where is my mouse? It was the wrong one. And yeah, and if you are interested, all of these are always up on pixelfantasy.com. Thank you and good night.